Welcome to the first video of 2017 on my channel. So I've decided to film a first impressions cross full face of makeup tutorial because there's lots of makeup that's sitting to the left of me that I've been wanting to use for a while that I haven't got around to. So I'm going to use that. So this one is the Urban Decay Self Adjusting Complexion Primer, Adapting Pigments, Soft Focus Effect, and Shine Control. I don't know how you apply this. Do I use my fingers? But if it has pigment, I don't want to get it all over my hands. Okay, I'm going to use a brush. This is the Morphe E57. This is very peculiar. It's like lightening my face. As long as it doesn't affect the color of my foundation, I don't mind, but at this stage, I don't know if it's going to be undetectable. For foundation, I have actually used these before, but I wanted to show you guys because I love them. They're the Makeup Store Sculpt Excellence Foundations. So they're similar to Cover FX Custom Cover Drops, the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation, in terms of really, really high pigment. What color? I'm definitely gonna be a mix of both. I'm gonna use this little at Loz Curtis thing I was sent from Urban Decay. It's actually perfect to mix like foundations and stuff. Is that color gonna be okay? Using this, that's so gross. Good color, yes. That is satisfying. Using the Morphe G7, if you're looking for awesome face base brushes for concealer, foundation, stick foundation, you know, liquid foundation, the whole nine yards, even primer, the Gunmetal collection from Morphe is my favorite. I use the G35 for concealer if I don't use my beauty blender. I use the G8 for primer. I use the G36 for stick foundations, and I use the G7 for liquids. Amazing, I love them. Damn, this foundation is gorgeous. Wow, wow. I have a damp beauty blender and I'm going to use the rest of the foundation with the beauty blender because it's going to increase the coverage, but not cake up because the beauty blender absorbs a lot of the product. So you get a really full coverage, but you don't get like a million noticeable layers of foundation. I had a lot of people in my last tutorial saying, your concealer is too light, your concealer is too light. And you know, I respect your opinion, of course. But I very much like my concealer to be light. I'm going to use the Kat Von D Locket Setting Powder in Translucent. I know it's not really a big issue, but... Woo! This is the Morphe RO or R0. I've slicked my hair back and I'm going to use the Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray Cooling and Hydrating Oil-Free Paraben-Free Temperature Control Technology. The suspense when you've got a new spray and you're pressing the button to get like the spray into the little like straw thing and you don't know when it's gonna come out. Oh, my shirt is wet. Wet! Okay, oh my god, it's actually like shining my hands. Crap, this show is expensive and that doesn't look like it. Damn it, why do I wear things that I shouldn't wear when I'm filming? For my cheeks and blush and highlight, I'm going to use the Too Faced Sweet Peach Glow Palette. And yes, it smells amazing. Love the smell of peach, love a good peach. And the Sigma, this is the Morphe. Where's the Sigma? There's the Sigma F23 Soft Angled Contour Brush. I haven't used the contouring shade yet, but it looks to be quite subtle, which is up my alley. Rae Morris Deluxe Angle Kabuki with the peach shade in the middle. I also haven't used this. I have noticed that these need building. I'm like, literally, this is what I'm doing with my brush. I'm like, going in there, and there's no fallout, which is obviously great, but it's taking a while to build up. I really like this highlight shade. This is the Morphe M509 brush. You can kind of see that highlight. Time for brows. Yay! I am using the Makeup Store Premium Tri-Brow in Blonde to set them, using the Makeup Store Clear Brow Set Fix Clear. Oh my gosh, the other day I had an extremely light face of makeup on. I'm talking just mascara and eyebrow powder. And I didn't set my brows in place because I was like, you know what? They're not gonna move today. I'm not gonna do anything like any kind of rigorous activity, which would cause them to fluff out of place. So I just winged it. And throughout the day, I touched my face or, rubbed my eye or something. And I was like, my brows are so soft without the crunchy like brow gel. They're like little fluffy velvet caterpillars or something like that. For my eyes, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Rose Textured Eyeshadow Palette Rose Gold Edition. Beautiful colors. I mean, this has been out for a while, but I've literally only got around to using it now. I'm gonna be using these shades here, pretty much in order. That one, then that one, and some of that one, maybe some of that one. Using the Morphe M533. Why am I hungry and it's still always breakfast time? My stomach just grumbled. Like, yes, you're hungry, hurry up and feed me. These eyeshadows are blending out quite nicely. I'm going to use a bit of the next one, Henna, which is gorgeous. I'm using the Smith 232 brush. I'm going to go in with Henna again. Then I'm going to use Maneater, which is right next door, with the same Smith brush, and focus that in the crease. This is just going to make the crease even more like cranberry toned. I'm even going to bring that color into the inner corner a little bit, but I'm not getting any more on the brush. I'm just using what's already on the brush and blending it down, because otherwise it'll be way too intense. Then I'm going to go in with Coco, which is the one right next door. Carefully place that in the crease, in the very immediate crease. And even blend it over the outer corner of the eye. As you can see I'm doing now. Then I'm going to use Rose Gold. So this color here. Okay. You really have to put pressure on the eyelid to get it off my finger. But it's gorgeous. There's definitely fallout with these ones. I can see it on my cheeks and I can feel it falling onto my cheek. Okay, I'm going to go in with Maneater on the Smith brush. Oh, I hope this doesn't create lots of fallout on my cheeks. And I'm just gonna try and blend the edges of the eyeshadow and the texture shadow together. I'm going to use my Makeup Store eye pencil in Darkest Shadow to line my upper lash line. I'm going to apply the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara to my upper lashes. I'm going to smudge some underneath my lower lash line, but I'm not going to use the black underneath my in my waterline, because it's going to close off my eyes too much and I'm not looking for that for this look. So I'm going to use the Sigma E20 short shader brush with Henna and dust that underneath my lower lashes. You know what, I might even actually only apply that on the outer corner and not bring it all the way in. Then I'm going to take a little bit of Coco, which is the dark brown, and smudge that into my lash line. So I'm just making sure they connect in the outer corner. And then in the inner corner, I'm going to use Moon Dust. In my waterline, I'll be using the Benefit Eye Bright. So this is, of course, the opposite of what I was thinking about doing, which is darkening up the waterline. I'm lightening it up and opening it up. And then for my lower lashes, I'll be using the same mascara that I used on my top lashes. For lashes, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Sasha number 11 lashes, which look like this. I'm going to try this one. This is the Clinique Pop Lip Color and Primer in 04 Beige Pop. Definitely like a pinky beige. It's definitely not a brown beige. So while I really do like that, it is probably a bit pink for what I was after. So I'm gonna go over with another color to make it a little bit more nude. I'm going to go over with the Jouer Lip Cream in Buff. So this is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. It is definitely my kind of look with the really smoky, like pink, not pink, like maroony, burgundy shades on the eyes, nice long lashes, pinkish nude lips, and a really like nice flawless clean base. So thank you so much for watching, everyone. I love you all so much, and I will see you all in my next video. I am off to do some awkward posing. I hate it so much. I hate it. It's so like not in my personality to like go on camera, but I obviously need a little like the footage of it. So I'm gonna go do that. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye, everyone.